Baie welkom by die program hier op die vooraand van die lang naweek. In finansie program doen ons verslag oor die regeringse plan met pensioenfondse. Dan kyk ons ook na die jongste oor die aanvalle op vragmotors. Ons begin echter met 'n verslag van Ilse Marie Leroux. Komende Sondag vier Suid-Afrika Jeugdag, maar in 'n land waar daar soveel geweld is, word die kinders ook nie ontsien nie.
Suid-Afrika se sosio-ekonomiese probleme, soos werkloosheid, misdaad en armoede, het ongetwyfeld ook 'n impak op jong mense. Daar gaan skaars 'n week verby sonder 'n opskrif voor 'n moord of 'n verkrachtingssaak waar jong, onskuldige kinders die slagoffers is. Die Rooikruis Kinderhospitaal hier in Kaapstad se statistieke wys dat kinders nou meer as ooit beskerming nodig het. Die personeel hier moes vanjaar reeds 273 kinders behandel wat almal die slagoffers van misdaad was.
We saw at least 22 children that have been admitted with intentional burn injuries. We saw in the last number of months, in the last 5 months, we saw 17 children that sustained gunshot injuries. We saw 88 children that sustained physical abuse, 45 that sustained sexual abuse, and I'm trying to think neglect, I think was about 66 cases.
Hierdie skoksyfers is net vir een hospitaal in een provinsie. Dis egter 'n landwyse probleem. Die misdaadstatistiek het gewys, daar word byna 1000 kinders elke jaar in Suid-Afrika vermoor. Die getal kinders wat mishandel word, is nog hoër.
We've seen an increase in the numbers, we've seen an increase in the severity, we've seen a decrease in the safety net and the safety resources that exist within the communities. We've seen an increase in the severity of injuries, we've seen an increase in the combination of abuse that children come in. So not only do children come in with issues of neglect, but there's physical abuse that they've experienced. Over the years we've also seen a change where a lot more children are being admitted with physical abuse injuries. In the past, we saw much more sexual abuse, but now physical abuse has definitely overtaken those numbers.
Maatskaplike werkers skryf die toename toe aan veral alkohol en dwelmmisbruik. Van die gevalle van kindermishandeling wat onlangs aangemeld is, het selfs mense met jare se ervaring geskok.
We got a little boy from an area in the Western Cape who came in and he had multiple ribs that had been broken. He's 5 months old. Multiple ribs that were broken. Both his femurs. So the femurs, the doctor describes to us, is the strongest bones in a child's body, in anyone's body. And those bones were both broken. All the toes, all his toes were broken. Now one thinks, now how does someone break all the toes in on a child's body? He came in with evidence that his liver had been, there's a scar in his liver that showed that there must have been abdominal trauma. You know, how can that be ignored? How can our children endure that amount of neglect? How can children endure that amount of violence and abuse in their lives and not have long-term effects? And that's the fear that we have, is that the generation that we have that's been exposed to so much violence, what can we expect in the future? What is the generation in the future going to be like?
Enigiemand wat hulp nodig het vir alkohol of dwelmmisbruik of wat iemand soek om mee te praat as hulle die slagoffers is van aanranding, kan hierdie organisasies kontak.